complexities, causing us to pause as we collect our thoughts alone.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the SmackDown Women's Championship.
Make them top rated. They could taste the jealousy. I see their faces. I've been underestimated. I just tighten up my laces. They could get it. Now I'm breaking heads on a case by case basis. That's right. You should be scared of me. Put them down like that DDT. I'm a beast. Yeah. I live it. I love it. I do it. I does it. When I pull up, it's going down. Finish line, I can see the championship. It's me taking home the prize. I got a feeling they all in a feeling. The room and I'm bringing and shaking the ceiling. I break through the ceiling. There's no way to stop me. And I'm about to kill it. You got me, yeah.
Don't treat me like a woman.
Introducing the challenger from Ayrshire, Scotland, Doudrop. And introducing the champion from Redondo Beach, California, the SmackDown Women's Champion, the Night Wonder of the World, Chyna.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Elimination Chamber 5 as we open up Chyna defending in her second reign the Women's Championship. And we didn't quite get exactly what we saw at WrestleMania Backlash 3. As y'all know, that ended really quick, that triple threat match when, with Dakota Kai as well. Without question, that GTS that Dakota Kai hit on Doudrop contributed to her getting pinned when Chyna did the pedigree and a beautiful belt. No! Arm drag counter by Chyna! And picking up Doudrop! Oh my gosh! Beautiful! And by the way, just to remind y'all, Chyna is the first ever two-time women's champion, which is insane to think with how long we've been doing this for with y'all, you know? Beautiful back body drop from Doudrop. Back body drop from Doudrop. All that kind of rhymed and mixed well together. But Doudrop and Chyna here in the opener of the chamber going at it, yo. Only four matches tonight, but four big, huge deal matches without question. Especially our main event, the Elimination Chamber match. And this is the first Elimination Chamber preview where only one Elimination Chamber match is happening. But it is a big one, yo. And for once, we did not place the Elimination Chamber preview where it traditionally is held. It's usually between the Rumble and WrestleMania, but we had that. We had Vengeance Day instead to bridge between the Royal Rumble 5 and WrestleMania 5. But Elimination Chamber 5 is here. Although I believe next year we'll be going back to traditions. You know, so less than a year from the in-game time when this show happens, we'll see Elimination Chamber 6. And Chyna really going in on Doudrop. Could Doudrop become the second ever women's champion tonight? After that excellent opening to this match with Chyna doing the pedigree. And I'm sure we all were scared for Doudrop that just like that it was going to end right there. But Chyna landing in. She has the driver's seat in this match right now. Of course, I spoke too bloody soon. Doudrop going ham, going in on Chyna. Who slaps back? Who claps back? Capricorn DDTing Taurus into a cover. One, two, and a kick out from Doudrop. What a fun opening match to begin Elimination Chamber. This is already better than, let's admit, the disappointment that was that triple threat match at WrestleMania Backlash 3. Oh, that was so beautiful. Running senton from Doudrop. Very deceptively agile for a lovely woman of her size. And is that going to be it? Two-time women's champion Doudrop. No! And now, there she got it. Beautiful. And Doudrop again. But the ropes save Chyna. Unbelievable, not unbelievable, unbelievable hip attack. But the rope breaks. Continues to betray Doudrop. Beautiful catch right there. Catching Chyna as she's running. Million Dollar Dream slam into the ground. And there we go for the third time. Oh my gosh. One, two, no! Three. Chyna is taken. And she's not even close to losing. How the heck did she do that? Beautiful Harakarana from the champion. And it's even better fitting because these were the final two in this year's Royal Rumble match. Oh, what the heck? Oh. It's Legendary Diva, Women's Wrestling Diva, the Stratus. Well, that's her music. And Trish is in the ring with a chair onto the challenger. Referee, are you blind, you idiot? Oh my gosh, not like this. No, Chyna. No, oh, and Doudrop kicks out. Unbelievable. And pedigree, no. Nice tossing by Chyna, slamming the knee of Doudrop. And nice from Doudrop. Oh, and nice clothesline too. And Doudrop Ah! What? No! She is not done! Not by a frickin' long shot! She wants the guarantee victory! And that is it! 7 minutes exactly that fun-ass opener match lasted. And just like that, Doudrop reclaims her prize. The second ever, two-time women's champion, Doudrop. You love to see it, y'all. You love to see it. Love to see it. Congratulations, Doudrop. You earned it. Got a huge announcement right now, y'all. Trish Stratus vs. Doudrop at Payback, our next pay-per-view. Cannot wait to see that. I'm sure y'all are excited too. Let's get it.
The following contest is a 2 out of 3 falls match and is for the 24/7 championship. Introducing the challenger from Birmingham, England, weighing in at 205 pounds, the Bruiserweight, Pete Dunne. And introducing the champion from Dudley, England, weighing in at 175 pounds, he is the 24/7 champion, Tyler Bate.
And now, 2 out of 3 falls for the 24/7 championship. That was beautiful from Pete Dunne. Tyler Bate, one of the very few people in WWE history to have become a 3-time singles champion. There's Bishop Wilson, who is a 3-time Universal Champion. And I think it is Tyler Bate. He might be literally just the second ever 3-time singles champion in WWE. Oh, wait, and Dakota Kai. She's a 3-time Divas Champion. And Pete Dunne. Oh, my gosh! That was insane! How the heck is Tyler Bate still bloody functioning, mate? In this beautiful 2 out of 3 falls match between these two. For the 24/7 title. Is Pete Dunne going to become the second ever multi-time TNT or 24/7 champion? Tyler Bate, of course, the inaugural champion. Heck, he won it at this pay-per-view. Pinning Ribby last. Anyone remember Ribby? But Pete Dunne is going to let his anger known. He's quite angry about already losing the championship he pursued for so long. Straight away, mate. Oh, beautiful from Pete Dunne. And Pete Dunne. And this beautiful second match, 2 out of 4 matches of tonight. Beautiful technical masterclass. Oh my gosh, what a stomp, mate. And Pete Dunne, again, beautiful. Having an amazing technical match with Tyler Bate. And a go-go platter right outside the ring skirt, right next to the ring skirt, I'd say, here at Elimination Chamber 5. Oh, my gosh. Nice chop from Tyler Bate. Excellent stuff. And how the heck are we already 4 minutes into this match? Freaking time, man. And Tyler Bate, beautiful moonsault. Into a cover. Will the champion retain? 2. No! Ah! And Tyler Bate! Full 50 splash. 2. Oh, nice dodge by Tyler Bate into a beautiful back suplex. and Pete Dunne. Beautiful roll up by Tyler Bay. And oh no, this is how Tyler Bate won the title back. Is this going to be the first fall for the Bruiserweight Pete Dunne? No, it has not. Oh my gosh, beautiful. Oh, biting the fingers off the champion. Pete Dunne on the top rope now. Nicely done. And Tyler Bate on the top rope now. And that's it. First fall. No. The rope break has spared Pete Dunne from becoming the first fall of this great matchup. Tyler Bate, no stranger to defending these titles in 2 out of 3 falls matches, because at SummerSlam 5, he defended it successfully against Ilya Dragunov. And is that going to be the first fall? Better end? No, my God! Tyler Bate is one tough SOB, mate. One tough SO bloody B. I know I sound like a bloody Australian and I'm doing stupid accents spontaneously, but I'm a lover and a fighter. I'm a lover and a fighter. I know I'm singing Hardy by Jack. Sorry, it's the other way around, Jack by Hardy. Because I love WW2K23. And that's what's up. Oh, what a freaking powerbomb by Pete Dunne, the challenger. And just striking away, kicking away against Tyler Bate in this absolute technical masterclass. And Pete Dunne, he's letting Tyler Bate know who's boss. He wants that title back. We've already had one title change tonight. Will we see another? Will every title change tonight? Oh, just like that, Pete Dunne. One, two, three. Oh, just... we have yet to score just one fall, ladies and gentlemen. And no, once again, Tyler Bate, opposite corner this time. Beautiful roll up. No, and a kick out again by Pete Dunne. Beautiful counter, knees up right there too. Pete gonna butch Tyler Bate up, man. And beautiful enziguri right there. Oh, half camel clutch, whatever it's called. And Pete Dunne is it. No, Tyler. No, Tyler. Tyler Driver 97. That's it. First ball. Oh, what the heck? I don't know how Pete kicked out of that. How she shouldn't have. Unbelievable. He is determined to win back the title, Pete Dunne is. Tyler Bate knows this. Tyler Bate knows more than anyone what it's like, what it means to hold the 24/7 championship or the TNT championship when it was first announced. And by the way, we might eventually have it back to being the TNT championship. Still the same lineage, still the same title, you know. And Pete Dunne, beautiful suplex counter from the challenger. Tyler Bate is into this. Oh, paying a tip out of nowhere. Oh, out of bloody nowhere. Oh, nice again. Oh, nice. Gosh, that could be the first fall of the match. Ah! Oh my gosh! How is this match gonna end? 2 out of 3 falls. 12 minutes and no one fall. Oh, better end. And that has to be it. 1, 2, 3. And Pete Dunne lands the first motherfucking fall, motherfuckers. Can he go clean, or will Tyler Bate pick up the next fall to even tie the scores? Tyler Bate and Pete Dunne. Oh, beautiful. Sending out to the outside, Pete Dunne, I believe, has the support of the crowd, mother lovers. And Tyler Bate suplex again. Oh, what a slap by Pete Dunne. Oh, nice into the steps. 5-star technical classic we're witnessing right now, ladies and gentlemen. No ifs, ands, or buts about it, mate. Oh my gosh, right there. Oh, nice. And Pete Dunne. Oh! He's basically turning Tyler Bate into a freaking meat slab. With all this punishment he's been dealing to the 3-time and current TNT 24/7 champion. Oh, what a counter. How the heck did he not slip? That was badass. The way he kind of, you know, down like that. I mean, yeah, Pete Dunne could win this by count out. It'll get him this. Well, I guess he doesn't want to win it that way. Out the way, David. And Pete Dunne, what an amazing performer! Amazing non-stop technical clinic. 15 and a half minutes of rough, tough technical wrestling from two current greats. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no, 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 no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. No, no, no. I just couldn't. You know, when he took off the announce table cover, I'm just being stupid, mate. Pete Dunne luring Tyler Bate into his trap for one more bitter end. 1, 2, 3. And Pete Dunne wins back the 24/7 championship in a 5-star technical classic 2 out of 3 falls match. And he did it 2-0. Tyler Bate didn't get one fall, which just solidifies this win even further. Congratulations, Pete Dunne, champion once again.
The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the Worldwide Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 215 pounds, John Morrison. And introducing the champion from Dayton, Ohio, weighing in at 183 pounds. He is the Worldwide Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, Wes Lee!
And now, John Morrison, after his excellent performance at WrestleMania Backlash, has earned his first singles match whilst being the Raw Tag Team Champion. And what a first singles match to have. He is challenging Wes Lee for the WWE Championship. Is luck on John Morrison's side in his first ever singles match, let alone World Championship match, as he challenges Wes Lee for his WWE Championship? If we're going by tonight, I guess the answer is yes. Because, of course, there are only four matches tonight. We still got the IC title chamber main event. But, but the first two matches, we saw new champions. Oh my gosh. What is John Morrison doing? Amazing stuff, that's what. And Wes Lee toying with John Morrison, the Raw Tag Team Champion, Humpion at his finest. Oh, beautiful! Just like that. One, two, oh. Oh, and a beautiful from Wes Lee. Nice by Wes Lee. Oh, Morrison. That's going to do a number on Wes Lee. What the heck? How did he get up just like that? Wes Lee is not human. Oh, I missed that kick. That was a good kick, though. And DDT from Wes Lee. Oh, beautiful. And again. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Beautiful from Wesley. Ah! What an awesome match Wesley and John Morrison are having against each other, man. Like, for reals. And Wesley, Pele! Oh! One, two, oh! Who else thinks that should have finished him off? Oh, another. Or air collision by both of these men. Oh my, beautiful! This is for the WWE Worldwide Heavyweight Championship! Beautiful! I don't know what more to say when wrestlers do beautiful moves. When I'm just too into it, you know what I mean? And he tried to do it again, but this time John Morrison. Oh, and knees at the knees up Wesley. Absolute genius. Oh, nice. Oh, nicely done. What the heck is Wesley doing, mate? Hey, getting out a bloody table, mate. What is he getting a bloody table out, mate? And what else is he bringing out? A letter. He's bringing out a letter. And this, no, this is not an ODQ match. And Wesley can see the ref was closing in. Oh, beautiful! He just went over the top rope. Woo! Careful, Wesley. This is not no DQ. Heck, you already got the stupid ref taking out the ladder. Ah. Oh, he accidentally hit the ref. Oh, a beautiful spin-a-rooney type DDT. Oh, from Morrison. And the referee. You saw he was trying to do something to the table. Wesley did not like that to warn the pizza. Oh. Two. Ah. Oh. Wesley kicks out, nice. And, oh. And Wesley into the corner! Beautiful! He wants to do something to with the ladder. No, but John Morrison's getting up too fast for him to do whatever it is he wanted with that ladder. And up. Oh. I thought he was going for like a spinny DDT type thing onto the ladder. And Kamagoye from John Morrison. John Morosino. John Morrison, nice. Oh, and a Kamagoye again, and the stupid asshole referee being a stupid asshole, messing with the ladder that Wesley's trying to do something with. I know it's not DQ, but still, like, piss off, you asshole referee. Even Wesley's least telling him to piss off, asshole. Oh, and John Morrison. Referee Adon. That's making Wesley angry. And John Morrison. Wesley going back out for the ladder. And John Morrison. Oh, suplex. I guess his arm probably hit the edge of that ladder. Bow, chicka, wow, 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 chicka, wow, wow. I'm just making up stupid songs on the spot. As Wesley to John Morrison on our announce table. Oh my gosh. Oh, and oh, right into the bloody steps, mate. And Wesley. Oh, pushed off the ladder by Morrison. That must anger Wesley really much deep down. But Wesley still kicked out of that. Singles match for the WWE Championship. Wesley and John Morrison. Oh, nice flying kick by Morrison. This is a fantastic match. I was worried about this match, I won't lie. And Wesley telling the referee to piss off again. Hurricaning him onto the ladder. You love to say it, mate. Oh, and hitting Morrison with the ladder. Oh! And Morrison caught him into a powerbomb. Nice. And Wesley doth not like that uno bito. Telling the referee to eat his shots again. Oh, the referee in Wesley's way. That's going to make him angry. Oh, what a fall again, though. Into a kuva. And a kick out. Oh, John Morrison. Neck break out of Wesley. And the referee once again fucking with his ladder. He needs to. Excellent performance by Morrison in this match, I must say. And Morrison, no! Oh my gosh. The referee still screwing with Wesley's ladder. Oh, and a kick out from Starship Pain by Morrison. Heck, Morrison tonight could very well follow in the bloody footsteps of Uros. I'm just kidding. Of Wiz Lee's partner, Nash Carter, who was Raw Tag Team Champion when he defeated then WWE Champion Shinsuke Nakamura. John Morrison could be there too, because he's one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions now. Which, by the way, MSK never lost. They had to vacate after Nash Carter was made WWE Champion. Oh! Beautiful! The rope bait betrays Wiz Lee. Oh, dang, Wesley made the referee bleed. You saw that splash of red just now. And Wesley. And Wesley, oh. Nice. And a Wesley setting up another table. Oh, oh, poor Wesley. And man, Wesley trying to drag Morrison to the table. Morrison ain't having that though. Nice by Wesley. Wesley telling the referee to piss off again. Oh, and now John Morrison's bleeding. Wesley calls both his opponent and the referee to bleed. Oh, flip bottom just like that. Wesley not having that. And Wesley on the ladder. Wesley! Oh, that backfired big time. Oh my goodness. Nearly 20 minutes into this match. Wesley. And Wesley! On the top! And Morrison again! Oh. Is that it? Is John Morrison the dev? No! Kick out at one at that! Oh, and again, Wesley taking out the ref, and Wesley using the ladder against Morrison. And the referee's had enough of Wesley's attacks, and now Wesley is going ape on the ref, and Morrison wins by DQ. Oh my gosh, but despite that horrible ending, there will be a TLC triple threat between Miz, Morrison, and of course, the WWE Champion, Wes Alea. Main event time now, let's go. Suplex City, Suplex City, bitch. 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 30 seconds in, hit him with an F5. Hit him back so hard he feel it in the next life. Pull him over that shoulder just like a knapsack. Stocky man going down like the NASDAQ. No bonus revenge, I know that I'm winning. I know that I'm holding that title again. It's that Lesnar for president, no election. We dictate this ring from the start to the end. Gone, push him in the gut and hit him with a shoulder tuck. Hey, man, you know what's up. Spinning, flipping, man, we gotta get him overrun. Then we leave him like the covers, man, he folk know. First I hit him with a knee in the ring. Then he married to the sheets, let him sleep. Trying to suplex, I make the best falling. Ask me who's next, we tell him Seth Rollins. Dunk. Hit him with an F5. Hit him with an F5. Hit him with an F5. Money in the bank, now we hit him with an F5. Suplex City, Suplex City, bitch. Hit him with a German, hit him with an F5. Suplex City, Suplex City, bitch. Hit him with a German, hit him with an F5. Yeah, then we hit him with an F5. Yeah, we hit him with an F5. We'll be right back.
And introducing the challenger.
Seems like yesterday when the nigga had no luck. Seems like yesterday when the nigga had no bucks. Seems like yesterday when the world gave no fucks. Yesterday, today, I'm waiting.
These bitches know I'm the man. After the breakup, I gotta be started undercover prodigy. I've been in counseling sermons and churches, but still they can't get these fucking demons out of me. What's my philosophy? How'd I get the world to rock with me? How'd I get this killer following? How'd I go from being known in Panorama City to being famous? I'm boggling, everyone's mine. I don't go to bed as early, I be up all night up until 7:30 in the morning. My legacy's legendary, you won't ever catch a nigga stepping dirty. I know God has got me, I don't ever worry. I get it, by any means necessary. The haters want my career dead and buried. That's a long shot, fucking Stephen Curry. Bitch, I know I done revived my whole plan. Fuck the matrix, I had to break it, and now I'm the program. You won't ever catch me bowing down in the eyes of no man. Why should I be codependent? Motherfucker, I'm the golden ticket. This is my show and you don't get no admission. You won't survive a head-on collision, man. I'm so committed, I done broke a business. Was a business, the new UP coalition got you. I ain't all of this dough, I'm getting pussy. Niggas do not get no percentage winners. Time to rock, I'm the coldest with it. So don't ever question it, it is evident. Just when you thought a nigga fell off, I am back from the dead again. I am the revenant.
Life is a struggle, you know what it be like. For real. So I gotta get it, I'm sure you can see why. If niggas ain't eating, we hitting the green light. Come on, I'm about to put on for 818 like.
Bitch, I'm about to business. I got him talking dirty. Bitch, I'm about to business. A nigga poppin' lady. Bitch, I'm about to business. I see you watching, baby. Bitch, I'm about to business. A nigga poppin' lady.
My life isn't the same, why would it be? I got haters who think it so crookedly. I'm fed up, I said fuck it and took a leap. Now I'm killing shit, my nigga, look at me. A boss in the building, got niggas crying steady, caught in their feelings. I'm like a deadly Roman dog in the village. Just fuck them all if they involved with the villain. I shit on anything you thought was appealing. I hope you eating with the painted crease. I be feasting just to say the least. I might flee away and take a freak. Out to Fiji, maybe stay a week. Maybe three shit, I'm debating, geez. Hold the problems, will you make a cheese? Nigga, I'm a reinventor, 818. God damn it, I'm sorry, I had to stunt. Sometimes I'm a massive cunt. I clown niggas and I laugh a bunch. Dog shit, while I grab my nuts. I'm DMing all the ratchet sluts. My story doesn't happen much. I backed off, now I'm back for lunch. I packed the
punch. Look in my eyes, no fear. It's the big man time and the place right here. Nobody else, you feel the boom, go ahead, ring on the bloody bell. Cut your lights out, now go run and tell. Put the mic down right now, time to give a bass drum fast. Quick fast, you know like that, big blast. Big crash, you know like that, poor clash. Bomb blast, can't fight back, big flash. Camera man, record that. Look in my eyes, no fear. It's the big man time in the place right here.
And now, Mark Sanders begins our main event with the Intercontinental Champion John Cena, which is very fitting given that was the amazing main event of WrestleMania Backlash 3, John Cena, Mark Sanders. And now we have them facing off against each other inside the Elimination Chamber with, of course, four other men, including Omos, Brock Lesnar, Mark Sanders' best friend, Bishop Wilson, and Rey Mysterio. I think this is Rey Mysterio's first main event. What a beautiful crossbody by the Intercontinental Champion, the insanely longest reigning Intercontinental Champion at that. Oh, beautiful counter by Cena. Ah! John Cena has been Intercontinental Champion since WrestleMania 2. He has been Intercontinental Champion for 1,239 days. And Mark Sanders with a spear. And we knew Cena was kicking out, let's be real. But man, with all the other men the champion has to go through, you gotta think that that spear must have done a bit of damage, at least to Cena. And a starburst from Sanders to Cena. Oh, and he kicks out again. Oh. And Cena with Sanders in the corner. AA, Super AA. And Sanders, of course he's still in this. Of course he frickin' is. And now Rey Mysterio. AA! Just like that? No! To Rey Rey. And again? No! No! And Cena with the beard to Mysterio. Into a cover. Nice. And Cena trying to choke out Rey. And Cena to Sanders in the corner. And bumping Sanders and Mysterio to each other. But of course he is. And Cena, nice. I mean, Sanders, nice. And Mysterio and Sanders going at it. I don't believe we've ever seen them face one-on-one. What a match that would be now you think about it. And Cena with an AA again. One, two. Oh, still in this. And Sanders trying to steal the elimination, I guess. And Rey Mysterio, beautiful K2 to Mark Sanders. Oh, dodge spear by Mysterio. Mysterio dodged Sanders' spear. And Cena, oh, double axe handle. Inside the chamber. The main event of our pay-per-view, ladies and gentlemen. Who's next? Oh, and Cena thrown to the... And it's the Beast, Pork Laser. Pork Laser. Oh my gosh. And Mysterio and Sanders going at a suplex to Sanders by Mysterio. Oh, three amigos, actually. And Brock almost tried to do the suplex. Oh, F5, sorry. Emerald flash into Mysterio by Sanders. Sanders. Oh, Mysterio. Oh. And Cena and Lesnar. Oh, Mysterio. Oh, oh, nice by Sanders. And Brock, ah! And Cena knew it was coming. Beautiful one-handed bulldog to Cena as Brock and Ray Ray go at it. Go at Ortiz. And Cena and Sanders. Oh, beautiful takedown. Mark Sanders and John Cena have fought each other in the chamber before. That was when Mark Sanders was WWE champion. Heading to WrestleMania 2. And Rey's eliminated. Just like that. I don't know how. I wasn't paying attention to what the heck happened to Rey. But Rey is out of here. But thank you, Rey. You're a legend. And Mark Sanders picking up Bork Laser. Oh, tossing him out to the outside too. What does he have against people born in 1977? He's just throwing them out to the site, the thing there. Oh, this must... To see Rey's elimination though must be so satisfying for Omos and Bishop Wilson. Knowing they have one less cockroach to deal with. Oh, Mark Sanders tried to do the starburst. John Cena wisely let it go. And John Cena, nice neck breaker to Mark Sanders. Oh, John Cena runs right into an F5. Oh, that's it. Cena's out. No. Oh, starburst attempt. And now Bishop Wilson's in the suplex city by Brock. And Bishop has fought Brock in the chamber before as well. Oh, almost did the BW, but couldn't quite get it. This match is just getting more and more chaotic as the seconds go by. Oh, what a beautiful inverted suplex by Mark Sanders to his best friend Bishop Wilson. And Mark Sanders, Anaconda Vice on his best friend Bishop. He gets out of it, of course. Oh, nice takedown by Brock. Oh, BW! what the heck? Brock's taking it out. And Brock, F5 again. And Cena, what the heck? Oh, and Bishop kicked out at one. What the heck is going on? Oh, beautiful arm drag by Bishop there. Not the type of move we often see from that man. Beautiful flapjack as well. Oh, attempted BW. Oh, again attempted BW. Nice belly-to-belly from Bork Laser to Mark Sanders. And a super BW awaits the Intercontinental Champion. One, two, and Cena kicks out because of course he does. Now Brock's trying to pin Cena. Oh. Oh, attempted AA by Cena. Oh, now the final participant is coming out. It's coming up. It's coming out. It's coming out. It's coming out. It's coming out. It's Omos. Oh, Brock Lesnar. F5 to Sanders. Ah! One, two, and Sanders kicks out because of course he does. And now, every participant's in this mother-loving match, mother-lover. Oh, almost choke onto Bishop. And Bork Laser, who fought almost. And almost choke slam again. One, two, and Mark Sanders kicks out. Ah. Oh. What the heck is going on? Five huge men. Nice! Oh, did you see the way Brock manhandled Omos right there? Oh, nice by Cena. And Cena tossed to the outside again. Nice. Oh, taking him back out. Oh, nice by Bishop. Almost slamming the Intercontinental Champion. Oh, beautiful from Mark Sanders. And Bishop, oh, slamming down Sanders. And almost. Oh, big ass powerbomb. And Bork Laser. Just meat, bodies flying everywhere. Oh, almost choke slam to Brock. Oh, nice. Oh, nice. Neck breaker. Almost like a reverse BW right there. Oh, well, Mark Sanders trying to do a spear. And I think Brock was trying to do Suplex City. AI! We haven't seen one of those for a while in this match. Uno, dos. Ah! Oh, beautiful. Oh, what the heck, Mark Sanders? How did he reverse that crossface thing? Into that crossface thing, I mean. And Omos choke! And Brock Lesnar going Suplex City on the Intercontinental Champion. And, I can't tell if I missed a few things that are happening. And Mark Sanders, how is he picking up Omos? This match is meat everywhere. AA for the 6AA. Oh, and Brock's out. And Bishop kicks out. I've been trying to keep count of all the finishes in this match, but I have been like keeping the tally, and then I hear pin counts happening on screen, so I might have missed one or two. I hope not, though. I hope my calculations are accurate, because if my calculations are accurate, there's been 0 619s, 6 AAs, 2 spears, 3 F5s, 4 almost choke slams, 2 BWs. Without question, there are more to come. Up your ass. This is just pandemonium, beautiful violence for the Intercontinental Championship. Almost looking to take down Cena again. Oh. 1. 2, and Cena still kicks out. Unbelievable. Not unbelievable, unbelievable. And Jonathan Felix Anthony Sanation the second junior with Super AA to Omos. That is it. 1, 2. Ah! No! Despite all his rage, John Cena is still just a rat in a cage. And yes, I've been listening to that song a lot lately. I don't love it anywhere as much as when I first heard it when I listened to it for the first time in my friend John Hexton's car. And that was in 2011. Oh! Cena. Oh, nice. Picking up Omos from Cena. And Bishop. Oh, nice counter by Cena. I can't possibly keep track of everything, y'all. This is basically a fatal four-way now. And Cena picking up the ship. Ah! BW! And it still isn't enough to put down Omos. And a spine buster to Mark Sanders. Uno, dos. And Sanders kicks out. Bishop's beating people with that move. Oh, BW attempt. Nice kick. Oh, what a kick by freaking Omos, mate. And Bishop almost to Sanders. Cena telling almost, oh. Cena's not scared of Omos. Cena's beaten Omos one-on-one before. I think Sanders was trying to spear Omos. And an 8th AA. Still isn't enough. Omos is soaking finishers like a sponge. And a choke slam and a starburst. Ah. Ah. Unbelievable. How is everyone kicking out of all these finishers? Oh, man. Beautiful counter by Cena to Sanders. And a beautiful inverted suplex from the Intercontinental Champion. Alabama slam. Alabama salamama. Beautiful. And Omos. Once more to Cena. Ugh. And Omos. Ah. Oh, yeah. Omos and Cena, man. Beautiful. That sounded like I said Cinnamon, like from the chase. And Cena. One more AA to Omos. And that has to do it. One, two, three. Finally. Bishop, you can't jerk off during the main event match. Seriously. Everyone around the world heard those flapping sounds. Fabulo. Ah! Just like that! The 10th AA of this match goes to Bishop. One, two, no! Oh. Uno. Look at Marc saying his hero, his best friend, and him are the finalists in this amazing, legendary
Elimination Chamber match.
BW! Spine Buster again. Uno, dos, And Bishop and John Cena, one of the legendariest, maybe even the most legendariest rivalries in WWE history. And Cena kicks out of everything, man. Where did that come from? One, two, three, no! And again! One, two, Cena! He's on the house! Nice suplex from Bishop. Nice fisherman suplex from Marc Sanders. And John Cena. Five, knuckle shuffle. Bishop ruins it. Proto bomb to Cena. One, two, and Cena kicks out. And Bishop. Backing up Cena, sticking up. No. Luthers out of nowhere by Cena. He is just done with this match, is he not? Nice inverted suplex from Marc Sanders again. It is so hard to say who out of these three will win this match. But we have, statistic-wise, a higher chance of a new Intercontinental Champion. Given that the champion himself remains. And John Cena, the Intercontinental Champion, has, by the way, eliminated every single competitor in this match. Unbelievable. Luthers again. To Marc Sanders this time. Again. Beautiful clothesline. Cena picking Bishop up. I mean the other way around. Sorry. Jeez. Huffing off suplex. And John Powell bumped to Sanders. One-armed to Bishop. So violent. The main event of Elimination Chamber 4. Yeah.
And Cena still kicks out.
Oh! Bad choice to lay there and taunt! And a spear! One, two, no! And a bad double! One, two, unbelievable! And I that has to be a best. No! That was so close to three, though. We are more than 30 minutes into this match. And we still have three competitors remaining. Actually, two competitors remaining, because obviously one of these men will be the winner. And John Cena and Bishop. No, John Cena. Oh, no. John Cena with both Bishop Wilson and Mark Sanders. Shades of WrestleMania 4 to Keith Lee and Andrade. And Bishop's heart can't take it anymore. The crowd loves this. We are down to the final two. Mark Sanders and Jonathan Felix Anthony C. Nation, the second junior, who's both of these started this match in the first place. Full circle, this main event. 32 minutes. And counting. Beautiful diving arm drag by Sanders. And Sanders. Oh. Oh. Oh no! Couldn't quite get it there. Tried to super AA Mark Sanders again, just like how this match started. But Cena instead counters into a beautiful German. And Cena! Ah! Oh, Cena knew what he was doing. Making sure to dodge. Oh no, Cena! Cena suplex! Oh! Oh no! Oh! Oh my gosh! Cena striking all heck to the man who looks up to his hero, who has given him heck as Intercontinental champion. Oh, back body drop on the steel. That's insane. And Sanders. And now, Cena's finally, or maybe he did it before, able to do the five knuckle shuffle uninterrupted this time. Oh, no, Cena's gone all the way. Oh, he dodged the spear. Unbelievable. Very risky, but huge mistake from Sanders. AA again. Yeah, the way I said that. And that will cost Mark Sanders big time for this match. One more. Oh my god! Yeah! John Cena single-handedly eliminated every other competitor in that main event. 7 BW, 6 chokeslams, 3 F5s, 4 spears, 14 AAs. Unbelievable. And the main event of Payback will be those three yet again. It has to happen. Triple threat for the Intercontinental Championship. Thank you all for watching Elimination Chamber 5. Peace out, y'all. Good night.